All right, for the marathon bombings tonight, the New York Times is reporting that the Russian government declined several requests for information about Tamerlan Tsarnaev years before the attack. Our Phil Lepoff is live in Washington, D.C. tonight. And Phil, this information came out after a congressional hearing there today.
It did, Ed, and that congressional hearing focused for the better part of this morning on the lack of information sharing, believe it or not, that contributed in part to the Boston Marathon bombing. And tonight we are learning probably the most egregious example of that comes from the Russians. The Inspector General's report puts the blame squarely on Russia, saying the Russian government refused to give the FBI additional information about Tamerlan Tsarnaev 2 years before the bombing. The New York Times says Russian officials told the FBI in 2011 that the older Tsarnaev was, quote, a follower of radical Islam and was prepared to leave the U.S. to join unspecified underground groups. But when FBI agents in Boston asked for more information, the Russians refused and only gave up that information after the attack on the marathon.
I'd like us to take a moment to remember.
On Capitol Hill, a moment of silence inside this packed hearing room. Members of the House Homeland Security Committee, for the most part, honoring what is the one-year anniversary of that attack. Then, high praise for five members of the Watertown Police Department. All were involved in the takedown of the Tsarnaev brothers. Their chief wearing a Boston Strong pin with this.
I mentioned our goal was to be the best police department in the state, and I'm not sure if we reached that. But I can tell you one thing, for 8.5 minutes, we were the best BAM police department in the world.
It was mostly praise for how Boston handled the attack and the hunt for the bombers, but the committee's biggest concern was information sharing. The FBI for sure, but even between Boston and Watertown.
I really think that, that we may be being holding this information too closely in the interest of a prosecution.
Something Congressman Keating says proved to be deadly 1 year ago.
We're going to work to see if we can change some of the codes, and there seems to be a strong sentiment to do that.
And I spoke with Congressman Keating's office late this evening, probably about an hour and 15 minutes ago, and they do confirm that the congressman himself will be briefed on the Inspector General's report first thing in the morning. Live tonight on Capitol Hill, Phil Lipoff, WCVB, News Center 5.